Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Dmitry channel. Today we're going to continue talking about alternative operating systems, and today we're going to talk about Haiku OS, and I'm going to run it on this machine. This is a ThinkPad T61. I initially wanted to run this alternative OS on Mac, but it didn't work on Mac. Some kernel panic occurred, so I don't know. I actually really like Haiku OS because this OS is not Linux based. It's not anyhow trying to emulate Windows like React OS, for example, does. It's just simply alternative operating system that you can try, and it recently entered the beta stage. I grabbed the latest copy of this OS from the official website. I'm trying the live CD. So right, I'm gonna boot it from it right here. I actually really like the splash screen right here. It's very like promising. You can see what's going on here. Kind of feels like old fashioned because I used to be seeing somewhere, oh, probably it was BeOS, where this kind of splash screen was going on. I wish it worked on Mac because this splash screen is very beautiful and it looks very nice on the Retina display. I'm still trying to figure out how to run this on Mac. All right, this looks promising. You can install it directly on your machine, and you can also try as a live CD, boot to desktop, typical in Linux distros as well. All right, so we have it all booted. So let's see what we can do with it. I wanted to change the desktop background, so I press the right button, and here I can select, no, I guess not here. Deskbar preferences, yeah, you need to press the start button, deskbar preferences, and okay, I think I forgot. So first I want to try to check this icon right here. Here, like the Fido icon. I liked it. And then, well, how to actually, I forgot. Preferences, appearance or backgrounds. Backgrounds, oh yes, backgrounds. Here, what we can do, we can set this Haiku logo. I'm not sure, like it was selected by default here, but it was not appearing, so you need to actually select it once again and press apply. Then you can configure colors, which is kind of nice. And then as always, you can just configure the positioning of this logo. It's kind of nice. I like this kind of style of operating system. Feels kind of old school, but at the same time, it's very fast, very efficient. Like, what do you need? And then let's go to applications. And here we have actually a bunch of apps available. Among all those applications, what's interesting was the media player. Let's try the media player. Very, very simple interface media player, and you can just play the typical files you play in the media player. And yeah, I actually like those icons, like very high color actually. In many operating systems, well, Linux as well actually, so icons are not the best quality. Here, like, I don't know, it seems like nice, nicely designed. About Haiku, when you press it and you have this, all the system information, I'm running this on Intel Core 2 GHz and memory 2 GB of memory. Here it has a link to the official website, and if you press, it opens the browser. Now I don't have the internet configured yet. I'm gonna try it in a second. And what I was interesting, like, what is this web browser based on? As you can assume, if you press about, you see, okay, Haiku incorporated, all rights reserved, and then you see the WebKit. As always, this web browser is based on WebKit, and this is kind of expected. So, well, it's good. I mean, the rendering probably is gonna be the same like in the Chrome, Firefox, similar kind of rendering, which is like, it's good. This is good, like it's compatible. So you should be able to run all your browser apps right here in the browser, which is great. You can already have some use case for this operating system, so it sounds good. Then applications, what else? Calculator, just a typical calculator you would expect. What else? Poor man, what is a poor man? Please choose the folder to publish on web. Oh, it's like a kind of Apache web server, I guess. What else? People. This is kind of interesting. Then it's like contact information. You can write like Nomadic Dmitry company, test company, just kind of contact stuff here, and then new person. And then new person, yeah. What else? Icon omatic. Oh, you can just like draw icons right here, I guess. How to do it actually? Well, I need to figure out how to draw it. It's kind of fast, I like it. All right, what else? Terminal style edit. Oh, this is like a typical text editor. TV. Well, I guess if you plug the TV card, TV tuner right here, you'll be able to see TV from there. I don't have anything, so I cannot show you, but I guess it's interesting. But I mean, why it's a default package? I'm not sure. Then web positive. What is that? Web positive is the name of the web browser. Yeah, it's kind of strange, but what's positive about web those days? All right, software updater. Well, if you have internet connection, it's gonna check it. Terminal. Where's the terminal? I saw it. Yeah, terminal right here. Welcome to Haiku shell. And I was expecting some weird syntaxes, but well, It's just like a typical bash you would expect from the Linux machine or something. So ls, ls, la, all the stuff that you expect. And if you type uname ra, it's gonna display you the full distro name, which is Haiku. What else can I show here? All the typical stuff. You can actually see the list of the commands located on the website. I can like touch, and let's type the name of the file, test.txt, and here it is. Created the file. I mean, all kind of Unix, Linux stuff you can do right here, which sounds great. What if I type if config? Yeah, it shows all the internet connection information. All good. So I like it that it's compatible and it seems very stable to me. I didn't saw any like driver kind of installation windows like I saw in the React OS, for example. It shows like, do you want to install this driver, this driver, this driver? I mean, like, totally nonsense, too much. This is like our activity monitor. Kind of memory usage, thread and CPU usage right here. So yeah, I mean, I really like this. It's really interesting to just explore the system, and you can use it for the modern task. You can browse the web, you can run the web applications right from there. Totally has a potential, and I think it's also international, because like you can open like a list of, which is probably gonna allow you to set, yes, different languages, formatting and options, translate application folder names and dashboard and tracker. And the Wi-Fi works out of the box. So if I select Wi-Fi, my Wi-Fi from here, it's just gonna connect to it, and like you don't need any specific driver, which is great. Alright, so I was connected to the internet using the Wi-Fi network, so let's see how it works now. So if I go to the positive, let's see how positive it is. And it works perfectly well. What if I go to like apple.com? It's a bit slow because I guess it's running from live CD and it takes some time to load everything from the CD, but at the same time it works pretty well. And I also like this style of like dragging the windows. You have this space available right here so you can see everything else, and this is the maximize button. This system honestly seems very nice, has a potential. It has also like a B-book. Talks about all the stuff available in the system right here. You can guys go check it out. The installer app is gonna install on your local machine, user guide, everything that you want to expect from the user guide. So guys, it was an episode of Nomadic Dmitry talking about the Haiku OS. And if you're interested, go check it out. It's a really nice OS. I actually go check it out from time to time, and I love alternative operating system. I think it has all those have a potential to become full-fledged replacement of the commercial operating system. So we can see in the future how it works out. But Haiku so far seems very promising to me. Thank you guys for watching. Bye-bye. If you like, press the like button as well. Thank you.